Hi, my name is Mark Renz. I'm an extension weed specialist with the University of Wisconsin-Madison and Cooperative Extension. And I'm here today to talk to you about pigweed identification. Well, pigweeds have long been common to the Midwest and Wisconsin. What we have that's new is we have a couple species that are rapidly spreading and becoming more established. In particular, we have taller common water hemp, which I'm going to refer to as water hemp in the future, and Palmer Amaranth. Why should we be concerned about identifying these species over other pigweeds? Well, their biology is a little bit different. First off, they're much more competitive than our other pigweeds. They produce more seeds and can germinate and emerge much later into the growing season. And secondarily, their ability to evolve resistance to many of our herbicides is much more common than these others. Therefore, we're really interested in identifying these populations and trying to manage them early and prevent them from spreading. So how do we identify them? We're going to focus on vegetative characteristics because that's really the time when we need to identify them so we can invoke management before seed production. And there's really a two-step process that's pretty easy to help identifying them. The first step that we want to look at is looking at the stems. So if we want to look at a pigweed here, we want to look right around in the middle of the plant and focus in and look really closely at that stem. What you'll see with that stem is it's got a lot of very fine, small hairs that almost look like a slight fuzz that's there and present. That's a really good indicator of red root pigweed. Now, smooth pigweed is another common species we have that also will have hairs, but it's not nearly as fuzzy as we see with the red root pigweed too. Those are two of our more common species. If that stem is not hairy and is absent in hairs, it's either Palmer amaranth, water hemp, or it could be spiny pigweed or spiny amaranth. This plant is also present in Wisconsin, but this one's easily distinguished because if you look where the leaf attaches to the stem, you'll see a distinct spine there. All you gotta do is pull this plant and you'll know that it's there and probably never touch it again because of its sharpness. Okay, so step one is to look at that stem. Now, if we know that it's smooth and we know it doesn't have or lacks hairs and we know that it doesn't have a spine, it's either water hemp or Palmer. What's the next step? Is we want to compare the petiole length. What's a petiole? It's where the leaf blade attaches to the stem with that stalk. That's what we call a petiole. We want to compare the length of that petiole to the length of the leaf blade. If it's longer than the leaf blade, that's Palmer amaranth. Whereas if that petiole that we see here is shorter than the leaf blade, that's water hemp that you're dealing with, a really nice characteristic that we can use to identify it. There's a range of other characteristics such as leaf shape that are different. There's lots of other resources available that can talk about this, but this two-step process of first looking for the stems, seeing if those stems have hairs or not. If they don't have hairs, it's one of three species, Palmer amaranth, water hemp, or spiny amaranth, and then looking for those spines present. If it lacks spines, then it's either water hemp or Palmer, then looking at the length of that petiole. Those are two really good characteristics to differentiate these species. So now that you know how to differentiate between these pigweed species, we're asking for some help. We'd like to have you report present locations of either Palmer amaranth or water hemp because these aren't widespread in Wisconsin. How can we do this? Well, we have several different options. The first option would be to contact someone in extension like a county agent. The second option would be to use a free app called the Great Lakes Early Detection Network. Please look at the URL in this video for information on how to download and use that app for free. Or the third option is to simply email us at reportapigweed@gmail.com. Now, in any of these instances, we're going to ask for some key information. The first piece of information we're going to ask for is the location, either an address or GPS coordinates. Second piece of information we're going to ask for is what type of habitat this plant was found in, like a cornfield or soybean field. And then the third piece of information we're going to ask for is some close-up pictures that allow us to confirm the identification of these species using the traits that we've just discussed. If you're concerned about herbicide resistance, you can feel free to add that into your report as well. This will really help us in understanding where these populations are in Wisconsin and to help with some coordinated efforts to limit the spread of these and potentially eradicate some of these species in local situations where possible. Thanks for your help and have a great day.